everyone, welcome back to Earl Grey Books. I'm Ellie, and today I'm doing a stationery haul. I have never done one of these before. I've always loved stationery, but usually more like notebooks, because writer, gotta have millions of notebooks that you will never use. But recently I have been getting more into bullet journaling. I started for the first time this year, and things just kind of exploded from there. So we're gonna get into it. Most of these are from indie Aussie stores, and then I have a couple that are from like big retailers here in Australia. I will link all of the indie stores below, their Etsy's, their websites, etc. And we're gonna jump into it. I'm also filming here today in my usual wrap-up spot rather than on the couch, because I think that I will be able to show you things better, and I will do some close-ups of stickers and things like that. So let's jump in with this one. This is from Elegance and Grace is the name of the store. I wanted to get this very particular brand of bullet journal, and these were one of the only people here in Australia that sold them. So that brand is called Archer and Olive. This is the little box that the bullet journal came in, really beautifully wrapped and like covered in like paper and everything. And I've taken it out of there, so that could have gone very badly. You can just stay down there for now. And then the bullet journal that I actually got is this one here. It's kind of this like I don't even know, it's purple. And it has gold foliage, leaves, and a little flower on there. I'm not going to show you the actual pages that I've done because I'm not very good at it yet. But it's just your standard bullet journal thing. And it has some really nice ribbons, two ribbons. And it is really good because it doesn't really bleed. There's a little bit of like, you can kind of see, but I think that's more the pens that I happened to use that time rather than the actual paper itself. So yes, I have that, and then I also from them got a bunch of little stencils. I think there's like 18 here, because I'm not a good drawer, so there's a whole bunch of different things in there and whatnot, and I will show you yes, so those. And then I also got another book from them. This is a sketchbook. This is from Fireweed. Yes, Fireweed Ink. It's just this beautiful, it's taped down. Oh, whoops. Okay, so it's just like a beautiful floral thing, and there's like a gold foil diamonds on there. So this is just a, like, it says it's a sketchbook, but there's also like a bunch of pages with like different pressed flower illustrations at the start, and then it goes into like brown paper, and then at the back there's just your standard white, and it has like beautiful like rose gold gilding on there. So yeah, that's really gorgeous. No idea what I'm going to use it for, but it was pretty and I bought it anyway. And then I also got from them this little set of cards from Notely. And these are native. They're called native cards on the back. And basically they are just these gorgeous cards of different native flowers here in Australia. It's kangaroo paw, I believe it's called. Wow, throwing things at myself. And yeah, real pretty stuff. These are designed and printed here in Australia, particularly in Brisbane, and they're also recycled. And basically my thought was that I would get them because they were gorgeous, and then I would send a couple to some of my international friends. So there are certain people who may or may not be watching who may find some of this in their mailbox at some point. And then also they sent me this cute little pencil case thing. It was free. I'm happy with that. So that's them. Let's move on to one that I didn't really buy that much from. This is a website called Washi Gang. They sell washi tape and also just your all other kind of standard stationery stuff. So I got four different types from them, and I will do close-ups of these because you're not going to be able to see them. These two here are both from Paper Geek Co. This one here is a pink mauvey sort of color with gold foil constellations. I'm a sucker for stars, anything star space related. I will buy it. And then this one here is also kind of like a, I guess this is like a lighter brownish color. This one also has some gold foiling. There's some stars and moons and planets and snakes on there and gems. And yeah, they're both really pretty. This one here is from Sylvan. They have a gorgeous little label. And then this is like a light purple and grey, and it has little owls on and what looks to be more stars and some trees. So that's really pretty. And then this one here is from Mindwave, and this is again stars and planets, and this is on a dark blue with gold foiling. There's some like astrological signs there, and yeah, really pretty. We'll definitely be spending a lot of money there. I haven't actually used any of these. I've been saving them up for this video. So I haven't used those, obviously, they're not opened. let's move on to some Etsy stores. So, got some stuff here and a little card. This is from Oxygen Crafts. They are on Etsy and I believe they're based here in Melbourne. And I got quite a few different things from them. First up, you're not going to be able to see these, so I'm definitely going to have to, I'm going to have to do the old beauty guru thing. But these are little violet stickers. I really like violets. And that totally has to do with a character in one of my books whose name is Violet. And she is amazing. So, yeah, those are gorgeous. And then I got these, which you cannot see what they are, but they are little grab bags of washing. I think I got, I hope that wasn't too loud. I think I got 20 or so. And basically they're just like little samples of different washi tapes. Again, I'll do a close up of some of these now. And yeah, I got, I think it came with 20 and like a few extras. And they were pretty cheap. And I thought it would be a good way to sort of test out and use some different patterns that I wouldn't necessarily pick, because as you've seen and as you're about to see, I tend to go for the same sort of thing. And then they also sent me this little package here, which is a bunch of just like little samples of things. I feel like I'm doing like an ASMR video, but I'm doing it really badly. So, well, there's some more washi tape samples. This one, I don't know what this says, but I think it says geek. And I now need to look at it because instantly my mind was like black with writing. Geek is the new, geek is the new sexy. And then it comes with little cutouts of like different paper, and there's some triangles and all sorts of things. So, I will definitely be using those up. I bullet journal now. And I also just like journal, I don't know, like my bullet journal is more like for like dates and things, and then I have a journal for like feelings and emotions. So yeah, I will sort of spread my stuff over those. And last up for the indie ones, this comes from a store called Apricus Notes. Sent me a little thank you gift. These guys are based in Perth, I believe. And I got just a bunch of stickers from them. So I got three individual stickers here, which I'm going to show you. This one says, "Heaven and Hell were words to me," which I believe is from Secret History, maybe. This one here, which is Resilient and Mighty, because sometimes I need a reminder that I am those things. And yes, so needed that. And then this one here says, "You are nothing short of amazing," which I'm going to be sending to a friend just as a little reminder to her. And then I got these, I think this one just came as like a little free one. Got a little envelope and "We Rise by Lifting Others" and some stars and some flowers and stuff. And then I got these three. I can't remember if they were, I think I got them all separately. I can't remember. So I have this one here that's got like a mirror and some teapots and books and candles and things, very cute. This one here is called Academia Aesthetic, which has got like a globe and like the like statue head thing, very cute again. And this one is Dark Academia, which has got another statue thing and some books and a camera and very, all very cute. And yeah, I thought they were adorable, so got those one. Now we're gonna get into some pens. I bought a lot of pens. or markers, I guess, really. And these are all now from like big retailers. So, first up, I got this from Typo, as you can see. I believe Typo and Cotton On are international. I don't really know. I've been thinking about this for years and I'm not sure. But yes, I got these markers. As you can see, I believe there's 36. They're all dual tip. And yes, there's a good little range there. They've got kind of my favorite colors. They've got like the most of. They've got a good selection there of kind of greens, which I really enjoy, and also some yellows and oranges, which I also really enjoy. These, I have to be honest, weren't quite what I wanted. These are more like, let me show you one. So yeah, this is a burnt umber. One of them is one of these. It does actually help. There we go. And then I don't really know what these are called, but this one is more of like a fineliner sort of thing. And I kind of thought these were more brush-y. That's kind of what they look like on the website. So a little disappointed. I do really like the color range and they are really nice to use, but I thought they were more kind of brush-like. Because literally like a couple of days before I bought a whole bunch of fine liners. These are the Stabilo 30.88. So there's 30 and then 0.88. I realized that. These are, not even kidding, my favorite like marker fineliner pens to use. I have owned many of them and I still have a couple, but I wanted to get like a range of them because the ones I have right now, I have a purple and a pink. So that wasn't really doing anything, but yeah, they're just kind of a standard, really, really thin. You can't see that at all, but I really like them for writing and that sort of thing. And I like that they're not thick. They don't bleed or anything like that. They're really easy to use and they don't go everywhere. So yeah, really like those. And then we get into Daisio. And I got four different things from them. So I got two sticker sets. This one here has little kitties on, and I'm just always searching for little cat things that look like Percy, and there are like never any that are like quite right. Like the closest one here is this little, like, he's kind of like a tuxedo, I guess, and Percy isn't quite that level. But they're really cute anyway. And then these ones are like little like playing cards, and I just thought they were cute. I really like the crowns. I don't really know what I'm gonna use them for, but they were pretty and they were like $2. So, and then I got these, which are just downright adorable. These are called I'm Curious About Niche Animals flake stickers. I don't really know what that is, but this one here is forest animals. There's like an owl in there and maybe a wombat and a fox and a sloth and croakers. So they're adorable. And this one is seaside. So there's a penguin, an otter, a shark, which are, not even kidding, my biggest fear. So I got those, and I also got another pack of the forest ones for a friend that I'm going to send to her because they're adorable and I think they will make her happy. And then finally, we had to take a trip to good old Kmart. And my Kmart recently has been really stepping up its game in terms of books, but like craft books and those sorts of things. And also I don't personally buy from there, but it's good to see affordable kids books and things like that. And also they have been stepping up their stationery, which makes me very happy. So I got a bunch of things. These are paper leaves. There's 16 pieces and they just look cute, and like I said, I can't draw, so using things like this, helpful. And then I also got this Pure Blossom mini paper stack. I'm gonna open this up. I think I own another or something very similar to this from Spotlight. I used to do a lot of scrapbooking as a kid. I didn't have many friends, so I scrapbooked a lot. But this is just, you kind of like two sheets of each pattern sort of thing. Pretty patterns in there, some blues and some pinks, which I really enjoy. And yes, excited about that. And then I saw these. These are two massive things of 10 packs of washi tape. This one is like a geometric art deco almost with metallics. So there's like a black with like a Tetris piece on. This kind of like marble one, this like rose gold glitter, this white and black triangle thing. Rose gold, some stripes in different forms, a black, a silver, and another triangle Tetris thing. And then this one here I really like. It kind of has that same geometric pattern sort of thing, but more in like a pastely gold. So we have the mint green, which you might be able to tell is slightly smaller than the other ones because I've used it already. A pink and gold, a like peachy fleshy colour. Blue and gold, that kind of colour with like triangle gold. White and gold triangles, pure gold, like circle rainbow sort of things. It's kind of like, I don't know, like lilac-y glitter, and then another gold pattern on blue. So yes, really excited for those. I really like the green in terms of quality. I was using it and it sticks really well and it's easy to rip and do all that sort of stuff. So yes, there we are. That is the stationery haul. I'm really excited because I've kind of been holding back on using this stuff. I'm filming this way ahead. It's still January for me. So I will hopefully have sort of used some of this stuff by the time this video goes up, and I will be able to talk more about it and whatnot in the future. So thank you all so much for watching. I hope you're doing well, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!